Okay guys, this is Trace, and I'm going to show you how to properly wick your coils. And I'm going to start out with some Japanese or inorganic cotton. First, you're going to wash your hands. You want to make sure your hands are nice and clean. A lot of people say you're going to get oil on the cotton from your skin, and if you wash your hands, you'll be fine. You don't have to worry about being oil. Alright, just going to pull off a piece here. Going to stretch it out. And then roll it up a little bit. You want it kind of even, like an even roll there, like even consistency. Alright, and I'm gonna stick, let me zoom in on this so you guys can see this better. Alright, I'm gonna stick one end in. If you don't have tweezers or hemostats, you can use your fingernails. I like using hemostats. And we're going to pull that through until it's tight. Nice and tight there. Alright. Now you need to see where your air hole is going to be, and your coil should be the same level as your air hole. So let's see here, it's about the same. As you can see, my air hole is about the same height as my coil, and I want enough to go down in the reservoir. Okay, now I'm going to put this down in the reservoir, like that, and then you want just a little bit touching the bottom of the reservoir, just like that. Okay, right there. Now we're going on to the other side. Kind of stretch your cotton out again. Nice, even. Twist. Point to us 100%. Just like it. Get close up on that. And you see how I did not fill the bottom of my reservoir with cotton. Then we want to take a loose piece of cotton. And we're going to fluff it up. Make it a little fluffier. And kind of fold it under. With this nice, even piece of fluffy cotton. And I like to pull it out and fold it under a couple of times. Because you are see a little piece of. Because you're forging this piece of cotton to be your just like kind of thin in the middle and thicker on the outsides, and then we're going to take it and lay it on top. And what we're trying to do here is put it in between the leads. But keeping it on top of your coils. Just like that. And you see that air hole? You can see the post in the middle. You get the air hole right below the coil, and that's what you want. You want the air hole right below the post. You can even expose the post in the middle. That's what I always do, is I always expose that post in the middle. It gives it a. It works out better for me. Alright. Then you want to prime it. Start from the top and work your way down. Kind of dab it in there. Make sure every bit of cotton is saturated. And what this fluffy piece of cotton is going to do in the middle is siphon this liquid up and down onto your coils. So, you're going to be dripping in the middle. And as soon as you start to see the reservoir fill up, you're good to go. Then you want to see this effect right here. And what it's going to do, I'm going to tell you what it's going to do before I even hit the fire button. It's going to shoot out from where the coals are on each side. See how it shoots out? down on each side. Alright, now what we want is our air holes to be right, exactly right where those coils are. And what it's doing is shooting that vapor out, and you're pulling it in. And let's do a quick vape on it. Let me zoom out. And we've got stuff laying everywhere now. And just throw these little pieces of cotton away. Let's do a vape. And the flavor is just awesome. You get a nice thick vapor and flavor. You feel the nicotine. That's what you want. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this. Take it easy. Give me a like and subscribe.